Greetings in the name of Jesus. Want to appreciate the Lord for this time and for everybody in this place. Everyone listening to me right now, I still want to say to you as a nation of South Africa, going through some few challenges that we are facing right now. On this Sunday, which is actually supposed to be the Easter Sunday, I want to give God the glory and the honor for his goodness, his grace, his mercy for sustaining us thus far. I told you before, I'm doing a series on leadership for the year 2020. But I'm using the life and the model of a man called David as a leader for this time. And I want you to listen to me as I show you some few aspects about this man. That most people just take him as a shepherd boy. But God used him and made him a great man. And as I spoke in the past, that God takes people that everybody undermines, uses them to become great people, uses them to touch the nations of the earth, uses them to change nature and generations. So the life of David has been such a great life. In the early years of ministry, the Lord told me to study the life of David. Actually, two people, David and Joseph, and understand their lives, because that is going to be a great lesson about where I'm going. So I learned about the life of David and also had a song that I like called The Shepherd Boy, which was sung by a man called Raybould. And through the song, I learned that God is able to take ordinary, simple things and use it to the glory of his name. And I want to share with you this very day that we are going into the life of David again and looking at what David has done, the impact he has made, and what type of a leader he is. You know, we always mention the statement, everything rises and falls on leadership. So when leadership is great, things become great. When leadership is bad, things will definitely collapse. In the politics, we see that. In the business world, we see that. In the ministry, we see that. Where leadership is not good, things never work out well. So we are learning from the life of David to see what type of a leader this was. Why did God choose him? Why did God use him? Why did God go so far with him? Why did he achieve so much in such a short time? And why up to today, you know, even Jesus was declared from the tribe of David? You realize the importance of this man's life. What impact has he done thus far? And you realize he's not a man who was faultless. He is a man who did a lot of things. But God was able to raise him, use him to touch and transform the world. So I want to speak to you today as an ordinary person as you are, maybe sometimes having faults. God wants to use you. You know, our church, Upon the Rock Center, our slogan says, where ordinary people are made kings. And I believe you might be an ordinary person and God wants to form a king out of you. God wants to take you from your ordinary life and create a king out of you. Change the lives of people. We are going through a very terrible time as a nation. We are under a lockdown. Most people can't go to work. This is happening. That is happening. People are struggling a little bit there and there financially because they can't go to work. A lot of things are not going very well. But we know out of these times, God is breathing us for something great. There's a great pruning coming upon our nation. And I am looking forward for great things that will come out of our nation. I'm looking for a great time where our nation will experience the goodness of the Lord in the land of the living. On this very day, as we are experiencing God, as we are expecting the fulfillment of the Lord, I want you to open up your heart, open up your ears, and listen. Invite someone, call on someone to listen with you so that we can speak into their life with this day. I believe as God touched me, he wants to touch you. As God healed me, he wants to heal you. As God uses me, he wants to use you. And as we will go to the word of God today, we're reading from the book of 1 Samuel chapter 17. We will not read all the scriptures. I will quote most of them. And I still say what I always say. When I give scriptures, go home and read them. Read them verse by verse, word by word, precept by precept, so that you can be able to judge what I say or be able to confirm what I say according to the word. The Bible says the Christian in the church of Berea always made sure they go and check what the apostle said to them using the word of God. The reason why Christians are deceived, lied to to led astray, it's because they never study the word on their own. They wait for someone to come and tell them the Bible says this. Go study the word on your own. Nobody will deceive you. Nobody will lead you astray. You will always be on the right side because you're reading the word. So go and read 1 Samuel chapter 17, verse 1 to verse 44 for yourself. Go through it. Every verse, it will change your life. You will understand what I'm talking about today as you go through these scriptures. Now, on this scripture, you will discover we are talking about a time when a man called Goliath was challenging the nation of Israel. Oh, right now where we are seeing a sickness called coronavirus, challenging the nations of the world. It is today's Goliath challenging the world. But I want to say to you, wherever there's a Goliath, there is a David. Wherever there is a Goliath, there is a David. If this sickness is a Goliath, God is about to bring in David. And the David will change the nations of the earth and show them that our God is alive. We serve a mighty God. We serve a God who never fails. I can stand and speak like David. I've been young and I've now grown old, but I've never seen the righteous forsaken and his children begging for bread. I know God will not forsake us as the righteous. I know God is able to do anything that he says he will do. I've traveled doing crusades. And I've prayed for people in crusades. I've seen some of the most remarkable, amazing miracles. So I know we are in for a great miracle from the Lord. And I want those who believe with me, stand in faith and trust God. A season for signs and wonders. A season for healings and miracles. A season for deliverance and great wonders. It's about to come. And when that comes, the whole world will see our God is great. God cannot manifest himself except we go through challenges. And these challenges are there to prune us as a church. Let's pray for the nation of South Africa. Heavenly Father, we present this nation before you. We present even the continent of Africa before you. We speak right now by faith and say, this sickness will not lead unto death in our nation. But my Father, this sickness will see the encounter of the mighty hand of God. We call on your mighty hand to move in our nation. We call on your mighty hand to get into every city, every province, every village and liberate people. We break the back of this attack. We command it in the name of Jesus and we speak the healing power of God. Whoever is watching me right now and is sick, my Father, I send your healing power through these airwaves into their life from the crown of their head to the sole of their feet. I speak divine healing. Any form of sickness, affliction, disease, any form of disability, I speak into your life. Be broken by the power of Jesus. I speak to blindness, deafness, dumbness, crippleness, and any form of a sickness. Be broken in Jesus' name. Let this day be a testimony that you will tell people on that day when I watch this program, God healed me. God performed the miracle. I don't doubt his power. I don't doubt his ability. And there's no distance in the power of God. Receive it in Jesus' name. As we go into the word of the Lord right now, I want you to open up your heart and receive from the Lord and allow God to touch your life and manifest his goodness to you. I believe that God is able. Somebody saying, oh, but Bishop, you don't know what I'm going through. You don't know what I'm experiencing in my day-to-day life. But I want to tell you, he is a mighty God. He never fails. He excels in impossibles. He shows you that he is God of possibility. So this man called David had an encounter with a Goliath. And the Bible says in verse 8, you realize Goliath standing and saying, am I not a Philistine? Where is a man among the Israelites who would come and challenge you? And he kept on saying, if I win, you become our servant. And if he wins, we become your servant. He was so confident in his strength. The Bible says he has been a warrior from his youth. He was part of the sons of Anak, giants that lived on earth. There are situations in your life today that you don't even think of conquering them because they are sons of Anak to you. They are giants to you. They have been destroying your family from long ago. They have been there in generations. Nobody has conquered them. And this day, I talk to your such challenge, your situation,
the situation that conquered your great-grandfather, your grandfather, your father. It's about to bow this day in the name of Jesus. Because God is on your side. He will enable you to conquer it. This is the last time it's ruling and reigning. This very day, you have an appointment with God. It's not a mistake that you're watching and listening to me. You have a divine appointment with God for a miracle in your life. And you will walk out of this place. You will leave your seat. And whatever you're watching from, you will be able to say, I met God. David is able to conquer Goliath. Your Goliath will be conquered. So when Goliath was talking and saying, bring me a man that can fight me. And the Bible says the whole of Israel was scared. Not only was he saying that, it said he cursed them with their gods. He cursed God. He feared no one. There are people who fear no one. They don't even fear God. But there is a moment when God raises a David who will make somebody who doesn't fear God to fear. And I am about to tell you right now, as you're watching me, there's somebody you know who fears no one, fears no law, fears no God, torturing your life. Today is his last day. God is about to do something great in your life and show him that he is a mighty God. We are about to see who is greater between that Goliath and our mighty God. Now, God speaks as Goliath is screaming, saying, give me a man, give me a man. And we all know that David was a small boy. He was not included in the battle. He was not included in the fight. He was with the sheep, tending the flock. And as he was there tending the flock, the Bible says, David decided, I want to go and see my brothers. And he prepared lunch boxes for them to go and give to them. A leader is able to go an extra mile for others. He went an extra mile for his brothers, brought them food in the battlefield. A leader does not neglect people who are going through battles. David did not neglect his brothers who are going through the battle. There are many people who are with you when things are okay, who forget you when you're going through the battle. Those people are not leaders. Leadership enables you to identify that this person is going through a battle, but I will be with him in that battlefield. If you can stand with people when they are going through the worst, leadership is inside of you. I can still say right now, not everybody is able to identify that in leadership. People who are able to stand with you during the battlefields of your life, those are leaders. Honor them, respect them, because they are there to fight with you when all things are bad. So David decided to go and see his brother. And sometimes when you're a leader and you're going to show good and kindness and generosity to someone, you are not aware that you're going to a divine appointment. You're not aware that you're going to meet your miracle. You are going to help someone, but your miracle is waiting for you there. David went to see his brothers. And when he got there, he found a man screaming, cursing the gods of Israel. And he realized, I cannot stand somebody who defies my God. We need to have people who understand what leadership is. Leadership is not somebody who fights because someone is defying him. Leadership is not somebody who demonstrates who he is when people fight him. Leadership is when somebody who rises when people fight his God. When you're a leader, you must have the ability to allow people to do whatever they want to do, and you're not shaken because they cannot reduce you. When people lie about you, when people criticize you, when people fight you, when people say everything bad about you, you still have 10 fingers, never lost any. You still have 10 toes. You still have 2 eyes. You still have 2 ears. Your nose is complete. Your body is complete. So why are you going to torture yourself? Only arise when people defy your God. But when people fight you, it's part of the journey of leadership. David never rose up because Goliath was fighting him. David never rose up when his brothers undermined him. David never rose up when they sent him to the field and they were living a better life. David never rose up when they wore robes and suits and they made him to wear the clothes of a shepherd. He never fought. He understood. Leadership, you don't fight people who undermine you. Leadership, you don't fight people who push you away. Leadership, you don't fight people who are against you. But leadership, you rise when people defy your God. And when they defied the God of Israel, David went on and said, who is this uncircumcised Philistine? Circumcision was a point of covenant, because Israel, when they were supposed to have covenant with God, they went through circumcision. So he was not talking it just physically, but he was saying, who is this man without a covenant with God, but defies God? I want you, as you're looking at me right now, child of God, you have a covenant with God. The covenant you have with God through the blood of Jesus gives you authority and power upon the people who want to defy you, who want to undermine you, who want to push you away. You are not just an ordinary person. You are a child of a covenant. You carry a covenant. Through the blood of Jesus, you had a covenant. The covenant of the blood is the highest form of a covenant. It is the ultimate covenant. Because of the blood of Jesus, you have a very high covenant. And because of that covenant, never allow anything and anyone to pull you down because of that divine covenant. Let the covenant of God stand with you and walk with you. Let the covenant of God be manifested in your life. And then David understood that this man is a covenant, not the covenant person. He's covenantless. He has nothing that should protect him, that should make him defy the gods of Israel. And he decided, I'm going to fight this man. I'm going to fight what this man is trying to do. The Bible says he went and started inquiring, what will the king do to the man who conquers this man? What will the king do to the man who conquers this man? Every leader knows this. When you want to be a great leader and you engage into any risk, find out what is God saying about that risk. What is God saying? Where is God taking you about that? What is behind that risk? And he decided, I want to know. And the Bible says when he did that, his elder brother, Eliab, realized that David is inquiring. David is asking. In verse 28, the Bible says his brother said, you stay away, keep quiet, walk away. Why do you want to interfere in this? You are a small boy. Every leader has people who would always say to you, you can't. You are too small. You won't make it. Don't even try. This is not meant for you. Let somebody else take care of it. Let somebody greater appear in this. Let somebody who is worthy be called into this. Every leader has somehow been undermined. There have been people who said, you're not good enough. You're not able to do this. And there are people who say, you're too proud. You want your name to be seen more than other names. David fought Goliath because Goliath defied the armies of Israel. Defied the God of Israel. And he went there. And his brother said, don't even try. Don't go there. Don't even try to go and fight this man. But David went ahead to fight the man. As the Bible says, he went to the king and spoke to him, Saul, and said, I am willing to fight this man. And Saul asked a very strange question. He said, whose son are you? He didn't say, who are you? And he said, whose son are you? Why did he say that? It's because in the battlefield, it always counts who is your cavalry, who is walking ahead of you. That is why I want to say right now, yes, we're going through situations where people are locked in their houses, where people have to watch their church services, staying at home. But the danger is most people might enjoy to stay at home and never go to church. But they don't know that immediately you are just a television Christian. You watch TBN. From TBN, you watch got TV. You watch this, you watch that, you watch that. And you never go to church at all. You never relate with any pastor. You never relate with. You lose what we call covering. You lose what we call covering. And when you engage in wars of life, the covering in your life means a lot. The covering upon your life means a lot. The covering upon your life declares that you will win this battle because there's a covering in your life. So they went to David and said, who's your father? And he said, I'm the son of Jesse. And when he mentioned that, the king understood. Jesse was not an ordinary person. So the king said, Do you think you can fight this man? And David said, well, let me tell you something important. I have a testimony. This is my testimony. When I was a shepherd boy, a lion came and a bear came to take a sheep. I chased them and I killed them and also rescued the sheep. So the same thing I have done to this lion and to this bear, I will do it to this Goliath. Now, I want you to understand the importance here. David did not just go and challenge Goliath, but he used the power of a testimony to challenge Goliath. I want you to know that every testimony you go through, everything you've seen in your life, whether it was in your 20s or you were less than 20, you were very young, that thing is important for the future battles of your life. God never uses people who have never been through a battle. That battle where you're struggling with money, where things were not agreeing, you never had accommodation, people didn't approve you, you did not know where you're going to stay, where you're going to live, you did not know what you will eat. That battle is a testimony for you to face the Goliath you're going to face right now. Every Goliath you come across in your life, you will conquer it because of a testimony. David said, I will conquer this man because I have a testimony. I have seen God before, and the God I've seen will be with me right now. Everywhere I go to preach, it's in South Africa, it's anywhere in Africa, it's outside Africa. One thing that holds me together is the testimony of what God showed me long ago. I always say, I've seen God doing it. I've seen God doing that. I've seen God doing that. Even this, he will also do. So I am confident. That's why I speak even before I preach. I said, I'm confident God will conquer this sickness. Why? I have seen God before. I've seen his faithfulness. I've seen his goodness. And if I've seen that, even right now, he will be able to fulfill it. He will liberate people, set people free. He will liberate people. He will conquer this sickness. He will bring this sickness to shame because we have a testimony. David did the same thing. Every leader carries a testimony. Is it poverty? Is it sickness? Is it strife? Is it the government against you? People against you? Opposition on all angles? I want you to look back. What did God do in the past in your life? Take the testimony and say, I have seen God before. I've seen him do this. I've seen him do that. He will do this again. I've seen him provide me there. He provided me there. He will provide me here again. That's how our God is. He is able to manifest his power using what he did before. If he brings what he did before, his mighty power will be revealed to you. God is able to manifest his faithfulness. God is able to show you his mighty power. So when David spoke about the testimony, what God did in his life, what God revealed in his life, how God touched his life, how God destroyed a lion, how God destroyed a bear when he went there, he knew that this is the same God who will conquer the Philistines. And David rescued the sheep, but right now he's going to rescue the nation from this Goliath. Before you face a Goliath of your life, conquer a bear, conquer a lion, have a testimony, and face a Goliath in your life. And this will take you to the highest level of your life. I challenge every Christian. I challenge every businessman. I challenge every politician and every parent. The battles you have won before are a testimony of what God is going to do in your life. Had you not gone through that pain, you wouldn't know how to call upon the name of the Lord right now. And I can tell you, the pains and the challenges, you didn't go through them because you are a Christian. Some of them you face them when you are an ordinary person. God allowed you to face them because you need them even today. Some of you will know you should have been dead long ago, but God protected you. That accident should have killed you. That sickness should have killed you. That day you walked during the night, you should have died. But God protected you for the time such as this. So that in this time, when everything has turned around and the devil is telling you won't make, you rise up as a leader and say, I've seen God before. I've seen him doing things. Every leader has conquered before. You cannot be an effective leader if you never conquered anything. You cannot be an effective leader if you never went through anything. If you never went through gossip, you never went through criticism, you never went through stampedes, blockages, hindrances, people closing doors, lies, persecutions. You went through them. You went through them. They are the reason why God is going to use you right now. Because God is able. Just as he manifested himself in the life of David, he will manifest himself to you right now. I speak this by faith in Christ Jesus. David said, this uncircumcised Philistine, I will destroy him. I will destroy him just as I destroy those animals. God is raising an army. God is raising you to destroy anything happening in the nation. Right now, I have this confidence. I have this faith that there's a generation of intercessors rising who will conquer the challenges of our nation and the challenges of Africa. There's a generation of people with healing gift, signs and wonders gift, miracles gift, who are rising to defy what medicine cannot handle. There is a group of pastors that God is raising this time who are not going to be motivators and entertainers, but they will rise up with power and manifest God. They will speak like Paul and said, I did not come with big bombastic weight when I brought the gospel. I didn't come with itching words, entertaining words that entertain and itches your eyes, but I came with words accompanied by power, simple words accompanied by power. So I pray today, as you are listening to me right now, that you become one of those people, whether you're an intercessor, you're a person with a healing gift, or you're a minister, or an ordinary Christian, that we are living in a time of confrontation. Just as Goliath confronted the nation of Israel, we have a confrontation in our nation. And this confrontation are challenging us. They are challenging who we are. But I'm raising you right now to become one of the testimonies of the goodness of the Lord in the land of the living. I speak into your life. This is the blessing I'm releasing to you. I speak as a bishop upon your life. I prophesy to your destiny that this day God will bring you to a life you've never seen before. I release this prayer over your life, your children, your family, and every beloved around you, that God's divine protection will be with you. The covering of the Lord will be with you. I will say this confidently. As the Lord is with me, he shall be with you. As the Lord has shown me his goodness, he will show you his goodness. You will never be devoured by any Goliath that come your way, but you shall conquer it. You will see the Lord. You will see his goodness. You will carry a testimony. You will tell the people, this is the day that the Lord has made, and I will rejoice and be glad in it. I challenge you. This is your divine appointment and encounter with the Lord. It will change everything in your life. From today henceforth, you will sing a new song. You will dance a new dance. You will speak a new language because God is on your side. I speak that blessing in Jesus' mighty name. Amen.